filming on phone and camera is so extremely different. Like, I could get away with a lot of things using the phone, especially hair. Like, your girl is hairy AF, okay? So, every now and then, if you see some mustache, some hair popping, just ignore it and look at this hair. Like, because the background is blurred, this is, you know, kind of seen more, like, all this frizz. And I told you in the previous video only that don't expect good hair from me after the monsoon end. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I know this is an entire different vibe, but I have to do this because I have a camera now and the whole thing was not working at all. And this is temporary until I move back to my house. Maybe I'll do some other setup later. But I hope this is nice because it's going to be a setup for a while. This video is going to be a beginner's guide for contour, blush, and highlighter. And I'm going to keep this as basic as possible, as simple as possible. I don't want to overwhelm you guys. You know, consider this as like, you know, a basic class. Like, this is the first class you're taking, and then you learn like more complicated things as you go ahead. Okay, so I want this to be as basic, as simple as possible, and I'm trying my best to keep it as basic and as simple as possible. So yeah, let's get started. So let's start with what is a bronzer. So bronzer is a powder which is 3 to 4 or maybe 5 shades darker than your skin. Now why do you exactly need a bronzer? So when you apply foundation or concealer, you're trying to cancel out all the discoloration on your face or redness or whatever it is. You're canceling it out and you're evening the entire skin, okay? Naturally, literally nobody has like the same skin whole color, single color on their entire face. Few people have like discoloration here, few people have discoloration on the eye, few people have discoloration around the forehead. Like, I have a natural tan which I have going on around my forehead. You can see, like, you know, these parts are naturally tan for me. So, you know, everybody has a different type of issue. So, when you cancel out the entire thing, your face is pretty blank. You don't have any definition or any warmth to your skin. So, a bronzer is very, very mandatory to add back that natural features which you are supposed to, like, everybody has these natural features, so bronzer is just going to enhance that thing. I'm explaining this so much because I do take classes and I know a lot of people will not have a bronzer, they'll not have a blush, but everybody does have a highlighter. I'm going to repeat this 101 times. I've told this before. Highlighter is not an important part of makeup. Bronzer is. Bronzer and blush are the things which are very, very mandatory. Like, if you're going to apply foundation and add highlighter, the highlighter maybe is going to give you glow, but that glow would not make any justice or would not, like, you know, matter at all if you don't have anything else which is defining your features. So a bronzer and a blush is always very, very, very mandatory to have in your makeup routine. Highlighter comes later, you can use it, not use it, that depends on your choice. But always, if you're going with a foundation, like, you know, going to even your skin out, you always, always, always have to have a bronzer. I'm gonna always keep these things short, but never happens. So anyway, so that is what a bronzer is. Now I'm going to show you how we apply it. Contour and bronzer are kind of similar, but bronzer is a little warmer and contour is a little cooler. There are warmer contours as well, like, obviously, but you know, contour is used when you want like excessive dimension, like excessive structure to your face. They're usually cool tones, like most of the time they're really most of the time very nice and contour. I'm very sorry. So contours are very like cool tone, basically grey tone, and bronzers are usually warm, like, you know, orange, not even orange, like brown, warm brown type of tones. So let's start off with bronzer, and first let's start off with the brushes I use for the bronzer. So these are the two brushes I like to use for my bronzer. You can see they're nice and fluffy. One is a little flat down, one is very fluffy, like, you know, brown type. So this is a Real Techniques brush, and this is a random brush I got off Shein. Like, I don't even think they're available. These are something I got 2 years ago and I still use them. They're really good brushes. So these are two brushes I like. I really like big fluffier brush for bronzer because I want my bronzer to dusted on my face, and I don't like to be precise. So I want to add the bronzer, but I want to flop out the bronzer as well. I don't want like harsh lines or anything. So I do really like this brush. And for my face size and you know type, these two brushes work really well. Obviously, these brushes might not work for somebody who maybe has a smaller face or a narrow face, depending on that. But for me, these two work really, really well. So we are going to go in with the KKW contour powder. This I'm using because you know they call it a contour powder, but it does a really good job, like the bronzer. Basically, this, you know, you can call this a 2-in-1 type of thing. So this is the KKW Beauty Powder Contour in the shade 6. So I'm going to show do's on the right side and don'ts on the left side. And I am, you know, watch this video entirely because I've seen people, I've thought people, and I see normally people do makeup, and these are the mistakes a lot of people do. And I am sure, like if you having your bronzer blush long, these are the mistakes only are coming. The most commonly done mistake, which I'll be showing, you know, on the don't side, and this is like how you're supposed to do, very very basic of how you're supposed to do. So the main and obvious step of your bronzer is where you place it. Now everybody has that standard rule, and that's how everybody explains that, you know, you're supposed to make, like, you know, do your contour. While doing this, you like you find your cheekbones. So this is my cheekbone, that is how you're supposed to do it, what they say. It is right until some point. But when you tell this and you leave for beginners, what they start doing, you can just start your, they go there, like this brush is clean, so I'm going to go there. So if this is the point of that cheek, they're going to start placing the brush right on that point. And they're going to start, you know, blending it and everything. So I'm going to show you that on the left side. So I'm just taking that bronzer and I'm going to like, so find my cheekbone, this is my cheekbone. So I'm going in with the brush, brush is coated, I'm placing it right on that part. Okay, this is how normally people do it because that's how they're guided. So now put it like this and they keep blending it. Now what happens is, though your cheekbone is right here, your bronzer or contour came down till here because you place your brush right in the center and you try to blend it out. Obviously, if you're a beginner, you won't, like, you know, really think about it, won't really understand it. But you know, this is how you did it. Bronzer came until the lower part, and this is going to make your face look extremely saggy, which is not, you know, what you want. So this, like, you know, people do this and you know they start blending this, and this is, you know, it comes here. Even I used to do this when I started out, but you know, through, like, you know, that practice and something, I figured out the best way to do it. So you know, this is how you do it. Like, you know, it's extremely low, you don't have any chin space left, it's kind of hitting here. And let me show you how you're supposed to do it on the right side. So now find your cheekbone, this is your cheekbone. Now take the brush, coat the brush on it, and if this is your cheekbone, start your brush up above it. Like, you know, the end of the brush should be on the point where your cheekbone lies. So what happens with this is, now the end of the brush is where the bronzer is ending. So you can see, like, you know, that wherever your cheekbone is there, there's a lot of dimension there, nothing like went down compared, like, you know, you can see this is like extremely down and this is like properly placed. So now after placing that, just keep on blending, tap and blend it upwards. Like, don't again drag it downwards, tap and blend it. So this side and this side, you know, you can see. So the placement of the product on the brush and the placement of the brush makes a huge, huge, huge role in, you know, how your product looks or how it's applied. Start on the cheekbone, end it on the cheekbone, and, you know, blend it upwards. So that's how, you know, you get that structured face. So like my contour, like cheekbone is here, there is a shadow going on like this versus like this is, you're gonna ignore this side. So I'm just going to do the same thing on the other parts wherever I, you know, bronze as well. So for the forehead, like, you know, people have really small foreheads. So for the those types of people, I don't think you want to contour. Like, you know, you just can, like in this video, I say contour, mention bronzing because it's kind of the same thing. So like, you know, they can just take a slight bit near like the hairline and just push it into the hairline just so that it looks very uniform. But if you have a bigger forehead like me, then you can kind of bronze it up. But again, here also same rule, place the brush like wherever it is. Now I take my contour till here, so I'm just going to place it there and I'm going to pull it into the hairline. Always blend the bronzer into the hairline. Now but on this side, if I'm going to, like, you know, place like the entire brush light right here, and if I'm going to do this, I'm going to end up looking so muddy because literally, like, you know, my whole brush is coated and like, you can see, right? I think it's pretty self-explanatory. So on this jaw, also the same thing. I like to follow my jawline and just do it. Versus on this side, a lot of people start bronzing up like this. Like, there's nothing wrong in doing this. If you want us to make, you know, face look smaller, you can definitely do that. But like, you know, this is like extreme. Like, don't obviously, like, you know, make it seem like you have a lot of bronzer here. Doesn't look really, you know, appealing to the eyes. So the same rule goes for cream contour or cream like bronzer. If you want, like, you know, use a cream bronzer, cream contour as well. Now, for the nose contour is for an entire different video. For now, I just like, you know, like to just bronze up my whole, you know, nose. I just like it that way. That's how I pretty much do it most of the time. If unless like I really want a very structured nose, this kind of I like the, you know, look this gives. So I just like, you know, do this. It just brings back the warmth to the nose and, you know, creates a little harmony to the face. So you can see, like, you know, once I added the warmth back to the nose, kind of looks pretty evened out and pretty nice. Always just tap with the brush, never ever, like, you know, what do you say, a stroke or rub the brush, because you did so much effort to, you know, lie down the foundation, the concealer, and then you powdered your entire face. So you don't just like go ahead and just stroke your face, not good. You saw, like, when I was applying, I was just like, you know, patting on the face. So always do that, and always before going in with bronzer or blush, make sure you at least, you know, dust a little powder on the face, because if like you don't set your foundation, there's a tendency that the bronzer is going to, you know, get patchy. Like, once you put your bronzer, like, you know, it's going to grab on the product and you are going to look really weird. And next on to blush, and blush is my most favorite part. And blush can be worn in various different ways, and it also adds a lot of structure and definition to the face. So according to me, bronzer and blush have to be, like, you know, very medium pigmented. It, you know, it's easier and a safe space to work with. If something is extremely pigmented, you know, you cannot go back. So it's always good to buy bronzer, blush, which are very medium pigmented, basically something you can build onto. For blush, I usually go in with two types of brushes. One is like this, again, sheen brush, and this is a BH Cosmetics number one brush. It's a very, very fluffy brush. So this brush is sometimes, like, you know, when I don't want to do anything and extremely lazy, I just want to add a full amount, like, you know, nice blush on the face. I take this and I just fluff out the color. And this brush is like when I just want to add the blush on the high points of my face and just want to give that a lot of structure to the face. But mostly I use this brush because I just love blush on my entire face. So while working with blush, one more point you really have to, like, you know, have in mind is work in layers. Don't go with too much product, and this goes for any product, that be foundation, concealer. Go in with less and then build up. Don't go overboard. This is something I always tell you. So let's take this blush. This is the Makeup Revolution Reloaded Blush in Coral Dream. I think so. Yeah, Coral Dream. Normally what people do is they coat their brush so much, like literally so much with the blush, and they, like, I'm scared to do it, and they just, like, you know, go ahead and apply it anywhere randomly. I mean, probably looks good on camera. I mean, I'm not mad. I apply this sometimes, but I always build in layers. It's never, like, you know, it never is too strong, like, unless it's really artistic type of makeup. So this is too much. It's too much in the sense that, you know, after this, now you cannot go back. Like, if you want to tone this down, like, if sometimes you think it's too much, you want to tone it down, you cannot go back. But if you're going to go in very small layers, then you can, like, you know, kind of just tap, like, little bit, take the product and lightly dust on your face. See, so it's like, if you want to go till there, you have a choice of going till there. It's not like, you know, the first time you're doing it, you're getting this strong of a color. So you kind of can, you know, start, again, I'm tapping on the face. So you can kind of slowly add the color, and if you can get it until this, if that is what you want, or you can, like, kind of leave it here. It looks really pretty. Like, there's, you know, nothing's too harsh or strong. So nothing, like, you know, too strong or weird. So you can, like, kind of take the smaller brush and apply it to the cheekbones and stuff. So basically, place your brush wherever your bronzer is ending. So you have to mix your blush into the bronzer so that everything looks very cohesive. I did use a stronger color. This is a very, very pigmented, you know, blush versus the Kylie one. The Kylie one, really less pigmented. You can build so much with it, and that's how I like it. But this is something extremely strong, so I just wanted to show, even if you have something which is so strong, you can still get this type of finish. But you have to be mindful of how much product you pick. You have to be very, very careful. Take very, very less product and then try and, you know, build slowly. Now, if you're going to apply it on the apples of the cheek, you're going to look more rounder. If you're going to apply it on the high point of your face, you're going to have more structure. So that's a choice you have to make, what how you want your blush to look. I like looking very chubby, so I just, like, you know, I love that, applying the entire color. But, you know, it's up to you, whatever you want to do. But always, like, be very mindful. You don't want to look very clowny, so don't just add a little pink here and leave it. You're supposed to start the blush wherever your bronzer is ending, and you're supposed to blend that into the contour so that it adds a lot of color to your face. I want to give one tip which you can use universally, is the placement of the product. I want to show you how to, you know, use any brush you have according to the need you have. Let's see, this brush is not maybe something which is very ideal to apply a highlighter. Usually brushes are, like, more convenient to apply highlighter if they have a little more rounded or floppy top, like, you know, something like this, but like in a smaller version. I'm not a big fan of fan brush, but I like something like that. But I do use this brush a lot, so I want to tell you, how you can, you know, utilize your brushes, like, in a multiple different ways. So the placement of the product matters a lot. Now let's take this same highlighter. This is very broken, so be very careful. So when it, it's a very, very beautiful highlighter. This is the Balm Marilou Luminizer. So this is the brush. So I'm first going to apply this on the right side. Now let's talk about placement of the highlighter. So just turn on the light and see where the light hits on your face. For me, this is the point where the light hits, you know, on my face. I'm just going to take the brush, coat the highlighter on just one side. You can see that I'm just taking one side of the brush and I'm applying, you know, the highlighter on that side. And I'm going to go in. And that is a lot of product I've added. And always, always, always blend in your highlighter. You're not supposed to just draw a line and leave. Even if you blend your highlighter, once the light hits, you know, you're going to get that type of glow. So always blend in your highlighter, looks very pretty. So now on this side, I'm going to go in with the brush like this. So basically that's how people do it. Like, you go in with just, if you have a brush, you just go in like this. And now, since the product is literally coated on the entire brush, so although I just want to apply right here, it's going to, like, you know, come all over the place. And this is how a lot of people highlight. They just, you know, do this and leave it because it just blows a lot. So this is how you do it, and they don't even blend. I'm still blending, but, you know, this is how they leave it. But I also, sometimes when I smile, light hits right here, so I like to apply a little bit right here. But that depends on, like, you know, how my skin is doing. Since I have texture going on, a little pimple going on right there, I would not do that right now. I did like that to just to show you that sometimes I do that. But since I have, like, you know, pimples or something going on, I have a little texture there. I don't want to enhance the texture while adding a highlighter, so I would avoid that. Now I can't go back. So if you have a lot of textured skin, then avoid highlighter. Always make sure you place the product on your brush very, very, you know, mindfully, because that makes a huge difference. You can see, like, you know, coating an entire brush and coating only one side, you know, has, like, a huge, huge difference. Now, last but not least is inner corner and eyebrow bone highlight. Inner corner highlight is something I always do. It just makes my eyes, you know, a lot awake. So much attention, so cohesive. I just wish I didn't have a pimple going on right here, right now, and the highlighter made it worse. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. If you have texture, don't apply highlighter. So if you look on the light, you can look, see, everything looks very cohesive. No highlighter here, highlighter here, highlighter in the corner. Looks very pretty, right? Versus, like, this side, though, I don't have anything to say. So yeah, guys, that's it. I hope I just have better hair and skin in this video. Anyway, I wanted to keep this as simple as possible. So I hope you learned something out of it. So we are going to keep building from here. But for starters, this is what I want you guys to master and learn. I hope this helps you, you know, improve your makeup and correct all the things you've been doing wrong. You know, even if you think you don't do wrong, try doing what I told you to do, and if it improves your makeup game, then that's a plus. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, then make sure you like, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell. It will mean the absolute world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.